one of England's finest and foremost comedians. We're very happy to have him with us. He's just finished his maiden debut here in America at the Roxy Theater in New York City. So let's show him what Milwaukee thinks of Lord Buckley. How about that, huh? Lord!
Hey, good afternoon, subjects. Ladies and gentlemen, I should give you a very short impression of a truly superb American. Yes, this gentleman's name is Mr. Louis Armstrong, and the title of the number, I Can't Give You Anything But Love, Baby. I can't give you anything but love, you little babes. It's the only thing to my job, whoa, mom's drip. Beam your dreams, scheme your scheme. Duck on my daddy, you find some happiness. And I guess the crazy little dad, would you want you blind was who? Love to see, looking swam. My baby, diamond bracelets, Woolworths could never sell. Oh, my mom, till the lucky day, you know darn well, I want you to die for heaven. I can't give you anything but Boochie Baby, Boochie Bowser. Ladies and gentlemen, we shall now take a little tour. Gad, what a large ashtray. We shall take a little... a little tour of the spontaneous realm of humor, using as a momentum a very new and difficult art called Mars Pantomimicism. Now, in order to create this high froid in artistic projection, are you there? Good. I will select from the audience as four members of either gender to assist. If you are so fortunate as to be asked, you will, of course, clap at once. Yes. And no dilly-dally. Are you there? Well, I've been telling you what is what. You delightful ladies and gentlemen have been dying for a cigarette, haven't you? Suffer. My little nicotine fiends. Only the king smokes here. His Royal Highness Lord Elliot and the royal lads will play a spot of American jazz. Bagao. Thank you. Judge Goldberg, he likes the baby very good. Yes, the judge, he very good boy.
Marches on. Ladies and gentlemen, through the lovely young lady and the three gentlemen seated on the chairs, through these four charming people, I will project four, hold your head up, Harry, four different and distinct voices. Each and every one of them will be given an individual voice to pantomime. They themselves will not say word one, but when they hear the voice allotted to them coming through the microphone, they will move their lips, eyebrows, nose, facial contours, and whatnot, hold your head up, Harry, in a pantomimic manner, thereby simulating actual speech. Now, Harry here will have the voice of Andy, the Structure Famous Andy, very deep voice. When you hear that voice come through the microphone, I want you to synchronize and move your lips to the sound of that voice. Beginning when it begins, quitting when it quits, and the results pantomimically should be this.
Well, it look like everything gonna be all right. Don't worry about a thing. Everything will find a dad.
Very good, Harry, but keep your head up so the people can see. Number two, that is Frognap here, ladies and gentlemen. Dr. Frognap, the well-known assistant dog catcher of the village. Frognap, hold your head up, Foggy. Dr. Frognap will have the voice of Brother Crawford, the official type, when it hits.
Well, my dear boy, I dare say we'll figure the matter out one way or the other. By gab, Frognap, you're in there like a mink.
Her Highness the Queen will have the voice of Madame Queen, a very high type of voice. When it hits the beam, she will throw you balls on the times how I feel about the situation. Very good, Angel. Number three, laddie, will have the voice of Amos Rossby type, when it hits.
Well, Jack, you gotta stay on the track. You ain't never gonna get back. Solid Mac. Now we are going to play
Little Theater.
Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. Through the courtesy of America, the first television broadcast of Amos and Andy. The time? The summertime. The beautiful, warm, golden summertime of Southern California. They're seated in a lovely Spanish garden in the fabulous San Fernando Valley, and it's sundown on the moon. Good heavens. That beautiful Southern California moonlight.
Hold your head up, Harry.
Shining right down in their eyes. Serenaded by the night birds, ladies and gentlemen. Oh, the beautiful sounds of the birds in the evening. Kindly leave that beggar what's supposed to do. They're very relaxed. They've had a double shot of tequila apiece, with the exception of the duo who's knocked himself out on a double 7-up. And a very new California drink called a Benzedrine Float. They are looking up into the moonlight, and Andrew is talking.
You know, it makes me so mad when the people start to talk about old Harry Truman. Because I think old Smiling Harry is all right, I really do.
What makes you think that, my dear Andy? Speak right up.
Well, Fog Knapp, to tell you the truth, old Harry Truman, everybody say he was going back up and back up and back up from them Ruskies till there wasn't no place to back up to.
Well, I got a little surprise there in Korea, no question about that. Plus, my boy, old General Douglas MacArthur, was over there. Let go of that left hook and hung it right up.
Yeah, you got something there.
Well, I'll say we all Americans. Everybody stay on the beam. We can't do nothing but win. Baby, you're out on the beam with that kind of jive, that's for sure. There ain't nothing I like better than a hip chick. Down hip your hip too, Daddy. Hip, hip.
All right. You see, this here age here, this ain't like any other age. This is the age of the anatomy bomb.
It ain't no firecracker, my boy, I'll tell you that much right now.
Well, they're talking about the A bomb and the Z bomb and this here bomb and that bomb. I'm sick and tired of them cats talking about bombs. Baby, I swear to goodness, I'll fall more in love with you every minute. I'm hip, Daddy. I'm hip, you hip. I'm hip, you hip, I'm hip. I'm hip, you hip, I'm hip, you hip. Hip, hip.
All right, yes. By the way, Crawfish.
What's on your mind now, my laddie buck, my dear boy, my good boy?
How you been a-feeling since you've been on the wagon?
Well, to tell you the truth, my lad, I've been feeling much better.
Is it true, Crawfish, that you don't take one little drink anymore?
No, my dear girl, I never touch it anymore.
But I can well remember the time when I would wake up in the morning with a horrible hangover. Have a cup of coffee.
There, like a fool, I would try a Coca-Cola.
Then, like a sucker, I would light a cigarette. Pow! Pichu! Pow! Pow!
I thought for a minute you were going to take off there, Crawfish. Tell you the truth.
Well, if I hadn't had my flaps down, I'd have made it.
Yeah. Well, we is going to relax and enjoy this here beautiful moonlight night.
I've never seen such a gorgeous night in my whole born days. Stars in the sky. Certainly do make a girl feel romantic this here kind of weather.
Sugar, you ain't got a worry in the world.
How come is that, you good-looking rascal?
Because you were sitting beside the greatest lover in the new United States of America. Is that the truth? That's what the man said, babe.
Yes.
Now I'm going to give you the most sensational super colossal kiss that you've ever received in your born days.
Mean to say, just like they do in the movies, Daddy?
That's what I said, Sugarface.
Well, come on, Daddy. I'm ready.
Well, here I come, baby.
Go, boy.
Look at it. For Hatchy balls, balls, bubble, booty, bees, bees, boom. Hidgy bubble, loosey bubble, la ba ba. Joe?
Sajo.
Listen, Jen, I want to meet my kid. It's a little Joe. I said, right, Joe? He's Italian. He's a nice little kid. Joe is a little Italian red pep. And he tickle his book, and a little Joe is going to play a little game. What do you think? He's going to play a little game called a Sicilian switch. I'm going to put here, Joe. I'm going to put here, Joe. I stand 1 foot in the hole, okay, Joe? It's a handy do nothing, Joe. You put it upside, eh? Listen careful, huh? That's a good kid. Now, hold your head up, Joe. You can see where it takes place. When I take your hat from your head and put it in mine, you take my head from my head and put yours, eh? Arrive at the patch at the same time, eh? That's good. Entire movement is synchronized about my right hand, eh? Hey, Joe.
Yeah.
No push it down so hard, please. A little son of a gun, he tried to bend me in two before he started his leg. Okay, Joe, pick it up. That's a little son of a gun, he got something. No worry, the other way, Joe. That's all right, watch what is taking place. Over here, Joe. Don't stop it now, Joe. Faster, Joe. Joe, what's the matter, crazy? Hey, Joe, when you come back, you grab the hat, eh? But he no got the hat there, no pull of the business, eh? Okay. A little mistake is okay. We're going to try again. Hats for my boy. Don't slug, Joe, I can feel. You're going to go now, Joe, slow motion. Got to go slow motion. This boy, try maybe ball like an eagle, 20 minutes. Mind your business, kid. Keep in the eye, Joe. That's so nice. How do you do? Nice to see you. How's everything? How's the mama, papa? Get off! Get off! That music's...